Obviously, with four brothers, we did a lot of fighting at home, and but judo taught us self-discipline, obviously. And the sensei of our dojo was a very famous Japanese judo sensei, eighth-degree black belt, Kawakami Sensei. And we just admired the heck out of him. So he was just a great role model for us, and I think it really straightened us out as far as how we should act. And so that was, you know, that was my mother's motive for us being in judo, to be disciplined. And it certainly, we certainly got disciplined. In the sport of judo, Jigoro Kano, the founder of judo, himself was an educator, a very distinguished gentleman, and his motto was to have self-discipline, to have maximum efficiency, and at the same time, by having maximum efficiency, he was talking about using technique rather than brute strength in competition and in workouts and so forth. But he also had another one, which was in Japanese is jita kyoe, which means to respect others, to do the best you can and help others. So his philosophy was not only to compete in judo and to wrestle and, you know, just the technique and strength and competition part of judo, but he also taught judo, or his philosophy was to make judo a part of your life, so that, and that is something that I think in the United States it's the same way, but particularly in Japan, that is such an important part of martial arts. And that's why judo is called what it is, the way of gentleness. It's what Kano invented. It was the way, a life. And that's that was the way judo was taught to me in Japan by my sensei. Well, when I first made the U.S. Olympic team, I was a student. And I was going to Loyola University in Los Angeles. And then after the Olympics, I transferred to San Jose State College. But I was in college at the time that I was an Olympian as a competitor. But when I became coach, I was at the Air Force Academy. And it was just an honor for me to, as a military man, to be a part of representing the United States on a level that is different from simply being stationed in Japan. So it was just a great source of pride for me to be a military officer as well as a Olympic coach. And, I just had just a wonderful time doing what I was doing. And as I say, it was almost a shame that they had to pay me. Not for me, of course, but it was a shame that I had to be paid to do what I was doing, because I would have done it for free. To begin with, it's important to understand the significance of judo in the Olympics. Jigoro Kano, the founder of judo, in 1912, he was the head of delegation of the Japanese Olympic team. And there were two runners in that team. And Jigoro Kano, the founder of judo, was the head of delegation. And he was so impressed with the Olympic Games that he did everything he could to have the Olympics take place in Japan. And so in 1938, they had announced that Japan was going to host the 1942 Games, Jigoro Kano was on his way home to announce to Japan that that was going to happen, and he died on that ship in 1938. But unfortunately, in 1942, that Olympic never took place because of World War II and the condition in the world. So that never materialized. Finally, in 1964, when judo became, or when Tokyo became the host of the Olympic Games, judo was introduced as the newest Olympic sport. And so for me, it was such a great honor to be on that team. And now, in 2020, the next Olympics will be held in Tokyo again. And there were four of us on that Olympic team in 1964, and George Harris, the heavyweight, has passed away, but the rest of us are still around. Jim Brigman, Ben Nighthorse Campbell, former senator from Colorado, of course, Yoshu Chita, the coach, and of course, myself as a lightweight. So the four of us got together a couple of years ago and said, hey, let's go to Tokyo in 2020 as a reunion. And that's what we're planning to do. You know, one of the things that when we talked about this in 2 years ago that we were a little bit concerned about was Yoshu Chita, our coach, was going to be 100 years old in 2020. But I've seen Yosh, you know, just a few months ago, and I'll tell you what, he's, 98, 99, almost 99 years old, but there's no worry about his health. He's going to be going with us to Tokyo in 2020. He's just an amazing guy.